We have Meredith Joshua, Finch Brook Inc., joining into the Ontario Subways, and Harshunta of Akhmatai Sabatram, who is our personal finance expert for the day. Afternoon, gentlemen. Let's get to our first caller then. We have Veena, who calls in from Mangalore, and she wants to invest a sum of 25,000 rupees in Tata Steel. Veena, go ahead.
Yeah.
Hi. Yes, your query?
I want to buy the Tata Steel.
Okay.
Is it right then?
Okay. What are the other stocks that you have in your portfolio, Veena?
I have six shares.
Okay. Oh, all right. And how much of the profit are you sitting on the Aishimoto?
2,000.
Okay.
One share.
Okay, I assume your buy price for Aisha Motors was 2,000 rupees per share. But anyway, Shri, I assume that you're going to sit on a good hefty profit on that one. But Mahesh, what would you recommend to Veena? Is it a good time to enter Tata Steel for 20,000 rupees? What could you recommend to her?
Absolutely. I think it's a great investment to Tata Steel. Again, I think the entry point should be staggered over the next 2 to 3 months. Yes, I mean, there have been increases in customs duties, both on long and flat products, and that should basically aid the domestic steel industry. However, if you look at the numbers that Tata Steel has posted on the standalone basis, as a part of our the realization is expected to remain weak in terms of what the situation looks like on ground. And again, I think the Chinese demand supply scenario is not improving. The analytical costs increase in the quarter on buying. That had a problem of the impact on margin, which came at 16%. Tata Steel dropped no better, so I think at $24 on an even number of basis, I think that was struggling clearly. So I think the next few months is not really a struggle when it comes to demand supply, realization still being a little bit muted. But again, valuations in our opinion are looking attractive. So on the domestic side of things, we're valuing Tata Steel's operations at 6.5 times EBITDA, internationally 5 times EBITDA. The only concern that I see when we got Tata Steel would be the higher iron ore cost inventory, which will still take time to phase out. And again, I think coming out of our plant expansion will take time. So I think in the next 2 to 3 months, why in a certain manner? I think we've got a nice target of 3 weeks on Tata Steel over the next year.
All right, after here on Tata Steel, up next we have Hari Priya, who's written to us from Mumbai. She says she wants to buy health insurance policy for her parents and herself. She says she can invest up to 10 lakh rupees for this. So Harsh, we don't know exactly what is the age of her parents, but considering that Hari Priya herself is 44, I guess her parents are closer to retirement. What could you advise them now?
So I think the key in health insurance really is availability. I think that's what I would like to tell her. Getting insurance for old people is very easy. We have had some past health issues, I mean, could be diabetes, could be blood pressure, etc. One of the things that you have to look at is whether the company that you are approaching is going to give you that policy. Most people look for floater policies for themselves and their parents, a common policy, and I think there I would recommend this Max Bupa Hybrid Family Floater that they have, where individually you can have individual covers of about 1 lakh and then have a family floater of 10 lakhs. It's not a very cheap policy, but I think all other features are pretty good in terms of the rule on type of them, in terms of there not being any co-pay requirement up to the age of 65, etc. I think the key is the company actually issues policies even if you might have diabetes, etc., which is a bit of an issue when you go to other companies. So that's a thing that I could recommend without really having complete details from Harupia.
Okay, well that's an important point that you brought up, Harsh, but let's now answer another equity call that we have, Mitra, who calls in from Kolkata, and she wants to invest in Asian teams. Mitra?
Hi, can I ask you something, please?
Okay, all right, 10,000 rupees is what you have?
Yeah.
Okay, all right, Mahesh, what would you recommend to Mitra, you know, Asian Paints hasn't really had the best year in 2015 as yet in terms of its top performance, but At current level, that 709 rupees worth, would it be a good buy?
So clearly, I think we should advise investors to wait for lower levels, maybe 680, 650, that range would be more appropriate for Asian Paints. Valuation is still a little bit stretched at this point of time, considering the financial performance that Asian Paints has meted out in the coming, in the quarter gone by. So clearly, I think EBITDA margins were under pressure. The volume growth that I was expecting at 5%, it clearly disappointed at 4%. But again, I think one must understand that it is one of the market leaders when it comes to the decorative paint industry. It might go through a lean patch or it might have bounced through a lean patch. And again, I think monsoons and weak monsoons, if I put it that way, I think we'll have some amount of say as far as the rural demand is concerned. So clearly, I think based on the declines, if those levels can become, I think it's the right time to start looking at stock. I think valuations will appear a little bit more less expensive at those levels. And then hold on for the next 12 to 15 months for a target of 780.
All right, Mitra, that's the advice for you, coming in from an expert, that perhaps you need to wait for the stock to correct a little bit more before you make your investment. Let's take a break on that note. When we come back, we'll continue answering all your stock as well as personal finance queries, and both our experts are going to stay with us. Take it.
We have Mitra who comes in from Mumbai, and he has investments in ITC. आपके पोर्टफोलियो में और कौन से स्टॉक्स है और उसका प्लस और माइनस क्या है अभी
जी नहीं अभी तो फिलहाल के लिए मैंने किसी कंपनी में इन्वेस्टमेंट नहीं किया है
तो आप एक महीने और के लिए रख सकते हो ज्यादा टाइम से लेते नहीं रिकमेंड टू विकास बिकॉज द प्रॉब्लम इज दैट ही ओनली हैज अ वन मंथ होराइजन इन टर्म्स ऑफ होल्डिंग आईटीसी सो वुड यू रिकमेंड टू हिम टू पॉसिबली टेक अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ अ हिट ऑन आईटीसी एंड मे बी ट्राई अनदर स्टॉक वेयर व्हिच कुड मेक अप द लॉसेस एट लीस्ट इन द नेक्स्ट वन मंथ सो hold on to ITC in anticipation of it coming back to 320 levels at least.
So clearly, I think because once I suspect it's very difficult for the stock to move because I think it is beating down for rightful reasons. I think this new secret plan, the cigarette volume decrease of 30% that we have witnessed is taking a toll on the margins of the company on a consolidated basis. Other businesses, including Agri, have shown degrowth in terms of the top line, 28% to be more precise for Agri. And though other FMCG held up, I think the other businesses will take time to mature. The core cigarette business, I think, will take some amount of hit. And even if demand and elasticity is still around, on cigarette consumption story as a whole, I think the top line will show muted growth going forward. So I think one really needs to give a good amount of time for ITC. The valuations are in the favor. So with the last perspective, very clearly, I think he could probably exit the stock and rallies. So like housing finance companies, I think something like an LIC housing finance is looking very attractive, and that can show some movement, in my opinion, from a short, medium, and a long-term perspective as well.
Okay, over a month. Longer for housing finance.
Well, yes, I think the story remains intact. So the asset quality has held up for a majority of these players. Valuation is not looking too expensive, and to one expects that's not to come if monsoons turn out to be calm. I think that over a longer period of time, I think the news and spread should maintain for these. So the LIC stands out for us in terms of both an earnings perspective as well as the valuation that it is currently deriving at. So I think LIC housing finance can be a very good long-term way as well.
No, it has really looked like housing finance has been doing favor. But Nitin, आपके लिए यही राय है कि एक महीने का जो टाइम होराइजन है वो बहुत छोटा है आपको अगर फंड की जरूरत है तो उसमें कोई आपको एडवाइज नहीं कर सकता लेकिन अगर आप होल्ड कर सकते हैं तो हमारे एक्सपर्ट की यही राय है कि आप इसमें बने रहें और इन चांसों को टारगेट दिखाई देते हैं। और अगर आप चाहें तो आप किसी हाउसिंग फाइनेंस कंपनी जैसे LIC में भी अपना निवेश जो है विशिष्ट कर सकते हैं, क्योंकि इसमें काफी बढ़त की जो है तुम्हारे संभावना दिख रही है। Up next, we have another query on personal finance. This time it's Vikas, who calls in from Noida. Hi, Vikas.
Hi, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
I'm new to the market and I want to invest 15,000 per month in equity. I already have 15,000 per month going in mutual funds.
Hmm.
And I have a long-term perspective and I wish to pay my home loan in the next 10 years.
Let me get this correct here. Already you need to FIP the 15,000 rupees a month in mutual funds, right? And you need to pay off your outstanding home loan. What is the balance that you have left?
30 lakhs.
40 lakhs. Okay, and now you are looking to invest a further 15,000 rupees, right?
Right.
Why particularly in equities? I mean, why not add this to mutual funds which you already have the FIP?
I believe if I would be able to build a good portfolio and then I would be able to get better returns directly in the market.
Alright, so first let me actually hand over your query to Harsh, because it's a serious case, Harsh, and I really think that Vikas here could do with a bit of advice. He has a 30 lakh rupee loan outstanding which he'd like to pay off in at least 10 years. He's 29 years old. He has a 15,000 rupee SIP already in a clutches mutual fund. And now has another 15,000 rupees per month to spare, which he's looking at direct equity. Do you think his risk profile will allow him to go for direct equity, or should he just add that 15,000 to his existing SIP?
Yes, I think there are two issues here. One, he also has a third option, which is paying off his loan more aggressively.
Yes.
He can I think this really needs, I would advise with us to take professional advice, simply because what is his risk profile is not something that you can do in a program like this. So if he, I think what he is really wanting to do is to earn more on this 15,000 rupees and therefore use that to pay off the loan, on which he hopes to pay much less. I think that really is what you are planning to do with us. Not necessarily a bad strategy. So I would very strongly advise you to just add it to the SIPs, and assuming that your existing SIPs are in good funds, just add, don't increase the number of schemes. You can add, increase your tips in those schemes. I think systematic investment in equity mutual funds gives you much, much better return. Direct investments, doing it itself as a systematic investment plan, doing itself is administratively extremely inconvenient, also expensive. Plus, it does not give you the diversification. I mean, it concentrates it. And you just think about it, what will 15,000 buy you? I mean, if you can at most buy you a few shares in a good blue chip, and you will continuously find it difficult administratively. Ideally, to just increase your SIP, provided you are already doing SIPs in good mutual
funds. Okay, so let's just ask him that, Vikas, would you know the funds that you are invested in currently?
Yeah. Yes, I'll tell you. I'm investing close to 4,000 rupees in excess long-term equity fund.
Okay.
And I have one ICICI Value Discovery Fund also, same amount.
Okay.
And one LBFC Balanced Fund.
Mm-hmm.
And I would start a large cap fund starting from this month. That would be either Bamba Family Fund and Equity or ICICI Super Exclusive Fund.
Okay, Harsh, to me they all sound like they're well performing funds, but what's your take?
Well, absolutely. All the funds that he has named are good. If he wants tax breaks, he can just increase the SIP in long term equity. If tax break under APC is an issue, because that is a real asset. Otherwise, obviously, either of the two funds he mentioned in large cap, I think what you mentioned, because whether it is group-focused blue chip or Birla Sun Life Frontline Equity are excellent large cap schemes. Just add one. Don't add two, is all that I would say. You already have three schemes. Just add one of them.
Okay. All right. So that's the personal finance query being answered. At this point, we need to take a break for some more stuff and personal finance queries, which will be addressed on the other side.
A few callers are waiting by for advice. Pradeep has called in from Rajasthan with a query on Supra. Hi, Pradeep. How can I help you? Pradeep, tell me, what's your question?
Supra ji, apne aage pe aur bas. Haan. Kisi ne aage pe aur bas.
Theek hai.
To jab aage pe aur bas.
Abhi aapko filhal paise ki zarurat hai. Agar long term ke liye aapko bola jaye hold karne ke liye, aap hold kar sakte hain. Okay. And normally aap long term investor hain, aapka nazariya lambe time ke liye rehta hai.
Haan, ye to hai.
और इसके अलावा कोई और स्टॉक्स है आपके पास?
IDFC.
ओके. ऑल राइट. महेश, व्हाट्स योर टेक ऑन सुप्रा? यू नो, आई एम ट्राइंग टू पुट अप अ वन ईयर चार्ट एक्चुअली फॉर दिस स्टॉक, व्हिच इज एक्चुअली सीन अबाउट 58% रिटर्न. The first person who is making a bit of a loss now, he is a long-term investor, would you advise you to remain invested in the hope of high returns from here? And if you could answer in Hindi, please.
Yes, madam. So I think clearly, Sitla ka performance dekhenge to thodi disappointing raha tha pichle quarter mein. EBITDA margins 13.8% pe aayi thi, jo expectation kafi high thi. हालांकि जो एड्रेसेबल मार्केट है इसे CFC इंडिया की 3 बिलियन डॉलर के आसपास है, बस ये भी तो कहीं ना कहीं कंपनी में एक दिक्कत सी हो रही है इन टर्म्स ऑफ टॉपलाइन ग्रोथ और मार्जिन एक्सपेंशन. और अगर ये पुष्टि होनी है इन नेक्स्ट 2 ईयर्स, आई थिंक टॉपलाइन एक्सपेंशन के अंदर 18% एडर बेसिस पे 16,600 करोड़ के आसपास, एंड जी शुड ग्रो 21% एज एज वेल इन दैट पीरियड. तो मुझे लगता है नियर टर्म एटलीस्ट कम लगता है 16 परस्पेक्टिव वैल्यूएशन थोड़े महंगे हैं, इसलिए थोड़ा एलोंगेट करना पड़ेगा आपका टाइम होराइजन 15 to 18 months, फिर होल्ड ऑन करें. फॉर्चुनेटली आई थिंक अरविंद फार्मा भी हमें काफी पसंद आ रहा है, तो अगर डिक्लाइंस पे स्टॉक मिलता है तो इसमें भी निवेश कर सकते हैं. अच्छी खासी है ये पाइपलाइन 364 एप्लीकेशन एक्टिविस कन्वर्ट करके 2 मिलियन डॉलर के आसपास इसका सेल्स क्रॉस हो चुका है और वैल्यूएशन भी बहुत महंगे नहीं है. तो अरविंद फार्मा भी आप देख सकते हैं 12 महीने के टाइम व्यू से मेरा टारगेट ऑफ 1650. All the stocks we've discussed, I do not have any personal holdings, but we have clearly discussed all these stocks with our clients.
All right, Mahesh. Thanks very much for joining in, and Harsh Arjun as well for joining in and taking us through your personal finance queries. For the Nifty, it's coming up quite smartly. So, your 111 is currently where we're at. They're up around 8.2%. The gap in Nifty also doing well. And with that, it's a wrap on this show. Do remember that you can keep sending all of your stock queries by posting it on our Money Control message board. Stay tuned. Closing bell is up next.